guys. This is a game of the heart. A game of being a man. Let's go.
For the Kansas City Chiefs, 1993 proved to be a journey of the heart.
So tired, baby. So tired.
It was a season of great achievement. The Chiefs were division champions for the first time in more than two decades, winning 7 of 8 games against their AFC West rivals. It was a season of legendary proportion. The presence of Joe Montana and Marcus Allen gave 1993 a special feel right from the very beginning. And at times, it seemed that the dimension they added was indeed magical.
He's running to the near side, cocks his arm, throws a pass on the fly in the end zone. Touchdown! Marcus Allen underneath the crossbar in the middle of the end zone.
Most importantly, 1993 was a season when no mountain was too high to climb, no obstacle too great to overcome, for a team that time and again displayed the character of a champion. In a season that fell one game short of the Super Bowl, the enduring memories will be many, but none will be marked more indelibly than this team's ability to conquer adversity, to thrive in the toughest of circumstances. It's what made 1993 a special season in Kansas City. The first Sunday of the 1993 season had a decidedly different look for the Chiefs. Their quarterback was new to Kansas City, but the results were vintage Joe Montana.
First and 10 for the Buccaneer 19, back to pass. Joe Montana sets up, winds up, hesitates out, throws a pass into the end zone. A diving catch, touchdown! And folks, as they say, this could be the start of something big. Joe Montana, his first touchdown pass as a Kansas City Chief.
A heavy and 17 wham. So that would put us about there. We're thinking about heavy.
17 wham? He said not to tear it, though.
You don't want to tear it? Okay.
388. Third and 7. Back to pass. Montana sets up. Pocket crumbling. Montana winds up. Arches a spiral down the near side. Over the shoulder catch of the 10 by JJ. Touchdown. Looking up into the bright sun of Tampa, Florida. JJ Burden has just caught a 52-yard touchdown pass by Joe Montana. What a play.
Sweet release.
Marcus is a halfback, 26 fullback arrow.
Marcus, you go right now.
The pass, Montana looks like, comes it off at the 10-yard line to Marcus. He's on the 5, he almost breaks a tackle, he dives in. Deliver the goods, Marcus, baby.
Montana had tossed aside 2 years of inactivity to throw 3 touchdown passes in the Chiefs' 27-3 victory. The Montana watch would be ever present, but the future was being built on the wings of the pass. The plodding of the past had been replaced by the firepower of the quick strike. And no one accepted the challenge more than the Chiefs' new look offensive line.
Come on, something to prove out here today. Let's finish. 1, 2, 3, go!
The Chiefs had met the challenge of change. Pro football is now a game played on the flanks with speed and quickness placed at a premium. Spread out the defense. Make them defend the entire field. Attack at all times. Thank you. also gives you the needed mentality to come from behind, which all teams must do during the course of the season if they expect to compete at the highest levels. For the Chiefs, one moment of truth came at the Los Angeles Coliseum on the 11th Sunday of the NFL season. They fell behind 14-0 and trailed by 10 at halftime.
And off Marcus, left side, breaks a tackle. Gets a block at the 40. Out in open field, 35, 30. Cuts inside, breaks another tackle, 25. The 20, he's gone. 15, 10, 5. Oh, they get him from behind. He's down. Frey gets the snap, hands off Marcus, left side, breaks a tackle. Takes a defender on his back. Into the end zone, digging in, touchdown. What a play. Marcus Allen with the touchdown. From the 34, first down and 10 yards to go. Frey, the snap. Fakes the handoff. A lot of time. Dropping deep in the pocket to throw. Winds up. There's a long pass. Davis over the shoulder catch. Alone at the 20. He'll walk it in for a touchdown. The Chiefs have got the lead. The Chiefs have captured the lead.
The final was 31-20. A mere prelude to the mid-December matchup against the Chargers. The AFC West title hanging in the balance for the Chiefs.
The Chiefs will need a Christmas miracle to come back as now they are down 16-0. To pass Montana, pocket crumbles, he moves up, he cuts his arm, he's throwing a line drive into the end zone. Touchdown Kansas City, and the Chiefs' Christmas goose is not cooked yet. Back to pass, Montana throws a pass, caught inside the 5 in the near end zone. It's a touchdown on the near side. J.J. Burton, an over-the-shoulder catch on a quick hitter by Montana. And the Chiefs have come back to score 20 unanswered points on San Diego.
The defense sealed the critical late-season win.
Freeze, the snap and the dropback. Freeze sets up, pocket crumbles. He throws as he is hit, pass, intercepted. It's picked off by Kansas City's Albert Lewis. He got it, baby. Oh, baby, what a play. The Chiefs have nailed down a win over San Diego.
Let's go, man. Focus. Finish. You know where we're at. Let's go.
In the 90s, the Chiefs are among the NFL's elite. In each of the last four seasons, only three teams have made the playoffs. The Chiefs are one of them. Every year, they have a shot at the Super Bowl.
Chiefs, we're coming Chiefs, to a town near
we're
you.
We're ready, buddy. Believe it. We are here to stay. Thank you, Mr. Peterson. We take our hat off you.
Consistent excellence results from success in two areas. You must defend your home turf, and you must control your division. For the second straight year, the Chiefs won 7 of 8 at Arrowhead. And their domination of the AFC West has reached epic proportions. 23 of their last 28 games against division opponents have been victories.
Handoff, sweep right side, Marcus Bigelow, 30, 25, cuts inside, got a block, 20, cuts across the other way, 15, 10, foot race to the 5, running to the far sideline, he's got in a touchdown! What a run by Marcus Allen!
In San Diego, the Chiefs faced a strong challenge to their AFC West supremacy. They trailed 14-10 late in the fourth quarter and were staring at 4th and 10.
4th and 10 from the 43. Back to pass Montana. Here comes the blitz. Joe moves up, cocks his arm, throws a pass. It's caught. It's caught for a first down at the Chargers 31-yard line.
In this special season of comebacks and character, the Chiefs scored with less than 2 minutes remaining.
Now Marcus right side, dives in, touchdown! I love this game!
Staying on top requires flexibility, the willingness to adapt when needed. In 1993, the Chiefs, as they did on offense, responded to the challenge and changed their defensive look. They switched to the 4-3, and right from week one, the results were positive.
Great job, defense! Great job! They got the ball on the 38-yard line. We hold them to a field goal. That side goes... We pump them up, and they get the damn thing going. That thing set the offense up for the score. Hell of a job.
Man, let's go.
In 1993, the Chiefs' run defense was the team's best in 22 years. and for the second time in 4 years, Kansas City was home to the NFL sack king. In 93, it was Neil Smith. Since 1990, no team has forced more turnovers than the Chiefs. And this season, the takeaway again proved to be an offensive weapon.
Back to Bassmeyer. He stands in the pocket from behind. He's hit, but he breaks the tackle and staggers free. Running to the near side. He's hit again. There's a fumble, and it's picked up. It's Derek Thomas, who's running up the near sideline. He's gone.
4 times in the season's final 9 games, turnovers turned the tide. Against the Packers, the ability to take the ball away was the difference between victory and defeat.
Fumble! It's loose! It's picked up by Sally Amua! Running lateral into the 15, down the sideline, 10, 5, they'll get a block, he's in for a touchdown!
Brett Favre, second down, goal to 3. Gets the snap, hands up, Thompson running over the right side.
He fumbles into the end zone! It's recovered by Kansas City!
Go on, defense! 3 weeks later, the Chiefs' pressure defense overwhelmed the Bills.
Second down and 9, Buffalo at the 31. Back deep in the pocket to Joe Kelly, winds up, he's hit! It's intercepted by Sally Moore at the 30. Down the sideline, 25. Gets a block at the 20. Down the sideline he goes. He's out of bounds. Oh, baby, what a play!
The Chargers had their attempt at a game-winning drive snuffed by an interception. And on the final Sunday of the regular season, the Chiefs' 11th win was secured by a fourth-quarter fumble recovery.
Going to the 10, recovered by Tim Newton at the 11-yard line. That'll do it. The door has been shut on Seattle.
In 1993, more fans filed into Arrowhead Stadium than ever before. In Kansas City, football is a passion play.
Chiefs, all the way, Chiefs! Yeah! We're number one! Number one!
A game at Arrowhead is a shared experience. And at no time does that emotion flow from fans to players as it does on Monday night.
It's our house! Let's make it big! Make it big!
On the rubber, baby. On the rubber.
In prime time, Arrowhead is Death Valley for all who enter. On Monday night, in early November, following the loss in Miami, the Chiefs' season could have unraveled. It was a game when character would reign. David Craig, replacing an injured Montana, directed a mistake-free offense. And Marcus Allen's fourth-quarter touchdown helped seal a 23-16 victory. In his first year in Kansas City, Allen was so much more than a great football player. He was, in every way, the man.
That's the hype, man. That's the guy.
That's my mentor, Marcus Allen.
Craig gets the snap. Hands off. Marcus at the middle of the 10. Breaks a tackle at the 5. Cuts inside. Breaks another tackle at the 1. Touchdown! Marcus Allen weaving through.
In Chiefs red and gold, Allen was revived, scoring more touchdowns than anyone in the AFC, and reaching a milestone less than 10 players in NFL history have accomplished.
Craig gets the snap, spins, hands off, right side by Marcus. He breaks the tackle at the goal line. He's in for a touchdown. That's his 100th career touchdown.
Allen symbolized the 1993 Chiefs. Tough, committed, resilient. Champions of the heart.
One thing that it proves, the one thing that makes this such a great game, you can talk all you want, but when you step across the white stripe, the only thing that matters is that 6 inches between your backbone and your breastbone.
We understand where it's at. Now listen to me.
For the division champion Chiefs, the playoffs began at Arrowhead.
Focus and finish. No distractions. Focus and finish.
Let's go work, man.
Montana was whacked and slow to get up. David Craig in for the injured Joe Montana.
Great pump back, looks right, pump fakes, arches a pass down the near side, in the end zone, and over the shoulder, leaping catch, touchdown, Kansas City! A spectacular catch in the corner by J.J. Burton!
Catch, man, what a catch! What a catch!
In this opening round matchup against the Steelers, the Chiefs fell behind 17-7, but this team, as they had done all season, fought back.
The pitch out to Marcus, gets a block, cuts inside, over the tackle, diving in, touchdown! They're on a roll, baby, they're on a roll!
Kansas City would have to reach deep again, and again. Trailing by 7, with less than 3 minutes remaining in the fourth quarter, the special teams made a truly special play.
Here comes the rush, and the punt is blocked! It's picked up by Kansas City! Fred Jones down the sideline! And Kansas City's got the ball inside the 10. First down and goal to go.
Cover two.
But first and 10 quickly became fourth and 7. One play. It would be a play that would define an entire season.
Get him in the end zone.
Let's go.
Get him in the end zone.
Go, Joe.
Fourth and goal to go. Not a more important play has been performed by the Chiefs than what is coming up right now. Back to pass, Montana. Cocks his arm. Looks right. No one there. Looks left. Throws in the end zone. Touchdown! He's done it! Joe Montana has done it again! The quarterback with the Hollywood name has just laced a line drive pass into the teeth of the Pittsburgh defense. And Tim Barnett has come up with perhaps the biggest catch in his career.
Don't count us out. Don't never count us out.
What's up, D-Town?
Nick Lowry will try to win the game. It'll be a 43-yard attempt.
Come on, Nick, baby.
Come on, Nick, baby.
Way to go, Colonel.
Come on, Nick, baby.
You can do it, Nick.
Come on, Nick.
This is for next week, Nick.
Parker to hold near hash, a wind at his back. Good snap, ball put down, the kick is up. Arching up, end over end it is. No good, Lowry missed. Lowry missed with 7 seconds remaining.
In one of the most compelling games of the NFL season, the Chiefs summoned the strength of character to move on. In overtime, they were finally rewarded.
Here comes Nick Lowry to try to win it for Kansas City.
Come on, Nick. Come on, Nick.
It'll be a 32-yard attempt. The snap is a good one. Ball put down. The kick is up. It is. Hey! Kansas City wins it. The Chiefs are going to Houston.
Hey, talk to the Chiefs.
Chiefs are going to win. And they're going to kick the Oilers' butt.
Everybody pick Houston. Yeah, we have a team. I give you something to go out and play for, won't it? I know it do for me. No respect.
Joe Montana?
Who's that, man?
Oh, that guy's 37 years old, ain't he?
I'm gonna take it to him today. Knockout, baby. He won't last the first quarter. Believe me, I said it first. Too much, baby. You got too much for me.
This is a game of the heart. A game of being a man.
I'll tell you what, I saw 96 and everybody there. I just tried to find somebody to hit.
Montana battles it all. Montana comes back to throw. Montana winds up, double punts, throws a long pass down the line. Oh, my God, he dropped the ball inside the five.
Oh. We got it figured out. Now we just got to keep grinding. We got it figured out. We got to focus now. We got to focus. We got it figured out.
Back to pass, Montana. Pocket crumbles. He winds up. Montana throws a line drive. It's caught. Caught by Davis, 40. Curls in the middle, 35, 30. Foot race to 25, 20. He's down to the... Fake handoff rolling is Montana. Cox is on. Dumps a pass wide open. Leaping two-hand catch made. 7-yard line by Cash. Angle to the sideline, the 5. He's in for a touchdown! Chiefs are on the board with 10-19 remaining. Third quarter of play.
In the hostile Houston Astrodome, the Chiefs again had to rebound from a halftime deficit. And this game may have slipped totally away from them if not for the record-setting play of the defense. 9 sacks, and 3 takeaways kept Kansas City within striking distance. In a remarkable fourth quarter stretch of less than 2 minutes, beginning with 9:37 left, the Chiefs seized control of a game few gave them any chance to win.
Montana backpedal sets. Pump fakes, there's a line drive down the middle into the end zone. Touchdown! J.K. Burton caught the Montana line drive. And the Chiefs have come back to tie with 8:38 left in regulation.
We may have to come back and do this again, Timmy. We may have to come back and do this again now, okay?
And Moon, the snap, the drop back, steps in the pocket, it crumbles, he's hit, a fumble on the play, it's loose, there's a pile, Sally Moon picks it up with a 10, he runs it to the game, oh, Pat Thomas stole the ball, oh, baby, what a play!
Back to pass, Joe Montana, looks right, after the pass, into the end zone,
a net handling, leaping catch, touchdown! I can't believe what I just saw! Montana Magic is back, alive and kicking in Houston, Texas!
Third and 2 at the 21. Maybe the game's most important play. And now Marcus. Marcus over the middle. First down, run, 20. 6, 8, 15, 10. 5, touchdown!
Gotta love this game!
Hey, you gotta love it, don't you? You gotta love it!
1:55 left as Marcus Allen sneaks his way up the middle for a touchdown. Oh, it's beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. We've got a Kansas City winner in the heart of Texas today.
I tell you what, we went out there and showed the best defensive line in the country and the best defense in the country that we can get 28 points on the big boys. And don't doubt us anymore. Now get out of here.
You played with great determination. You played with great heart. And whatever you do in life, whether it's this or anything else, if you play with your heart, if you work with your heart, there's nothing you can't accomplish. We had one guy that made a comment. His comment was, believe, believe, believe. And Derek, yes, we believed.
In 1993, the Chiefs never gave up, never backed down. It's a belief, an attitude fostered by Marty Schottenheimer, who has proven over time that he understands what it takes to win in the National Football League. This is an organization that has responded to the need for change and has met the challenges that consistent success in the NFL demands. The Chiefs are winners. They make the playoffs every year. And every year, they are legitimate Super Bowl contenders. That's the constant, and it makes every season a special season in Kansas City.